The key is then to take that video and give it to somebody who doesn't know anything about that, and then have them go through the process. If they pass and they successfully produce the desired output, boom, you're in business. Now you've essentially documented and you have a standard operating procedure for that one section.
You're listening to Flip Empire, the show committed to helping real estate entrepreneurs who want to build their empire without sacrificing their life. Your success and freedom starts now with your host, Alex Pardo.
Using something like Loom, use loom.com, I believe it is, or any type of screen capture recording software, you want to record how it is that you go about running comps, right? And here's a tip for you. One of the mistakes I made years ago was that I would record all these videos, and these videos were like 20, 30, 40, in some cases, 60 minutes long. And I realized it wasn't until I hired our EOS implementer, where he started to look at all our standard operating procedures. He started to look at all our videos, and he said, Alex, what happens if something in the process changes? Which, by the way, is bound to happen, and it's inevitable. And I was like, immediately, right when he asked that question, I knew where he was going. I'm like, well, that would suck because we'd have to recreate the video. He said, exactly. And he followed up with a second question. He said, Alex, what if you hand this off to somebody and they have a question about how to specifically do one thing? What do you do then? And I was like, you want to know what? I didn't really think about it. They'd probably either have to painstakingly watch the entire video again, or I'd just give them the answer. And so what I realized, and the takeaway from this, the punchline, is that take something like running sales or running comparable sales. You want to chunk that down into 3 to 5 parts, right? And then within each part, you might have 1, 2, or 3 sub mini videos. You want to keep these videos 3 to 5 minutes, and you want to title them well, so that if something in the process changes, all you got to do is recreate another 3 to 5 minute video. If somebody has a question about, for example, hey, Alex, what if I can't find comps within a 1/2 mile radius? What do I do then? Well, I've created a mini sub video on what to do in that specific case. Well, you're going to go 3/4 of a mile out, or you might go 1 mile out, and you start to kind of expand from there. So that's just an example. But that's one of the things you can do. Now, once you focus in on the non-revenue generating activity that drains your energy, that you just don't enjoy, where you find yourself spending a lot of time on, and you create the videos for that process, what you're then going to do is turn that over to a virtual assistant. Turn that over to somebody that can watch that video and create a detailed checklist, something that if I turn this video and this document over to a 15-year-old, someone that knows nothing about this, will they be able to produce the desired output? Will they be able to follow the standard operating procedure? Will they be able to understand the video and successfully complete the task? So once you do that, the key is then to take that video and that document and give it to somebody who doesn't know anything about that, and then have them go through the process. If they pass and they successfully produce the desired output, boom, you're in business. Now you've essentially documented and you have a standard operating procedure for that one section. You can then move on to the next thing on the list. If they cannot successfully produce the desired output, what you're then going to do is it's going to shine a light on where the holes in the boat are. It's going to shine a light on the things that you need to kind of go back to the drawing board and make sure that you address in the video that ultimately find them their way onto the standard operating procedure. One last thing before you go, if you have been listening to the show for a while and or you have been getting value from the show, I would be 100% honored if you would share this show with a friend, or maybe share it with somebody that you think could benefit from this. It's my mission, it's my cause, it's my purpose through Flip Empire to impact and touch people's lives, to help people and in their businesses. So it would be an honor if you would be willing to share this episode. And one last thing, make sure that you're subscribed so that you get notified every Monday and Thursday when shows get released. I look forward to connecting with you on the next one. Until then, have a great day.